This is Hollywood. Matías Bombal with you. Summit Entertainment, a Lionsgate company, offers a cinematic version of the true story of Lieutenant Laurel Hester, played by Julianne Moore, a policewoman in New Jersey whose struggle with cancer brings into focus the need for her to be able to assign her pension benefits to her domestic partner, also a woman. This was without precedent in her New Jersey city, and the long battle for equality before the city officials, whilst her cancer began to rob her of life, is at the core of what this movie is about, with some very fine performances. The movie begins with our introduction to Lieutenant Hester working on a drug bust. Not wishing to expose her sexual preference at her workplace or even with her police partner, she travels out of state to find some sort of social life. Following a volleyball league meeting, she meets Stacy, played by Ellen Page.
Hey, you leaving?
Oh, yeah, all kinds of work to do. It's a long drive home.
Where's that?
Ocean County, New Jersey.
Damn. You drove all the way out here to play volleyball and you don't even like it?
Every now and then I think she'd go out and...
try and meet someone.
Yeah.
And they don't have girls in Jersey.
It's not that. People know me back home. It's hard to go out and have privacy. I should go.
Okay. Can I have your number?
Watching Ellen Page in this produced the strangest sensation, as her mannerisms and gender-bending appearance reminded me of the look of the enfant terrible of the pop music world, Justin Bieber. As the two women grow in mutual respect and decide to get a home together, their relationship is tried by those types of growing pains found in any relationship. One is more controlling than the other, and each have different goals for themselves and each other. Lieutenant Hester's professional need to hide her sexuality at work also causes much frustration to the younger Stacy. The lieutenant's police partner is played by the always good Michael Shannon, here in a more human role than he is usually cast, and once more he sneaks in and almost steals the picture with his great performance. As the lieutenant's cancer gets worse, she appeals directly to the city freeholders for the ability to be able to transfer her pension to her domestic partner.
My name is Detective Laurel Hester. I've worked for the Ocean County Police Department for 23 years. I'm here today with my partner, Stacy Andre. In my career, I've never been afraid of injury or death while performing my duties. That's the job, and I love my job. Recently, I was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer. It's possible I finally met an opponent I can't beat. Please reconsider your decision and grant my request to assign my pension benefits to Stacy when I'm gone. When my heterosexual colleagues die, their pensions go to their spouses. But because my partner is a woman, I don't get to do that. In my 23 years as a police officer, I've never asked for special treatment. I'm only asking for equality.
Up to this point, the movie is relatively serious in nature, as the story reflects actual historical events. It is the arrival of Steve Carell as the Jewish gay activist Stephen Goldstein that livens and lightens the mood initially, but quickly becomes annoying. Goldstein brings protesters and drums up a media circus to put pressure on the city's freeholders about this case, drawing national attention to the little New Jersey city. The real-life events on which this picture is based are compelling. The performances of Julianne Moore and the riveting Michael Shannon further the proof of mastery of their craft. Hans Zimmer's score is appropriate and pleasant. The movie itself, however, no matter how compelling the story and performances, does not hold up well on initial viewing. It's a movie I wanted to like, but was just not overly impressed with. It seems the ideal formula for the forthcoming Oscar race, where generally a great actress, which Miss Moore most certainly is playing a person with a terminal illness, thus gaining the sympathy of the voting actors to vote in her favor. This has happened over and over in the past, and if there's anything you can rely on, even in Hollywood, it's the adherence to doing the same thing again that worked before. The Motion Picture Association of America has given this a PG-13 rating. This is your pal, Matías Bombal, bidding you a fond farewell.